Vendors Protection of Livelihood and Regulation of Street Vending Bill 2012, which aims to protect the livelihood. Which aims to protect the livelihood rights of the street vendors and regulate street vending through demarcation of vending zones, condition for and restriction on said vending. Before I come back to the major features of the bill, I would like to speak about the street vendors. As everyone here know, the street vendors lead a normal life. We can even say hand to mouth, all depending on the income they earn on a given day. They are not petty shopkeepers who have place to do their business. Street vendors, by the very name, denote that their business is on the street. They have no place to go or do their business. Under such trying circumstances, their life goes on. I hope this bill would go a long way in streamlining street vending across the country. Street vendors are often subjected to harassment by the authorities and officials. They have no protection, they have no social security, their livelihood hangs in balance all the day. Their life of hand to mouth. As per the report of the National Commission for Enterprises in the Urban Organized Sector, we have an estimated street vendor in the urban area in the range of 17 to 25 lakhs in 1999 to 2000. This figure must be double in the followed decade. The time is ripe to regulate street vending across the country. There was a proposal to extend support to the urban street vendors, and this aspect has been included as a component under the National Urban Livelihood Mission. Would the minister throw more light on this and the status? Would the minister highlight the major features of the revised national policy on urban street vendors? Has the ministry studied various policies at the state levels concerning street vendors? If yes, would the minister state whether some of the salient features of such state policies of street vendors are included in the current bill? What is more important about this bill is that it establishes a legal uniform mechanism for the regulation of street vending across the length and breadth of the country. Parliamentary Standing Committee on Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation has submitted its report on March 13, 2013. The committee took more than 6 months to go through the bill thoroughly and came out with a recommendation. The committee has made suggestions which should be considered and accepted by the government. For example, members of the town vending committee should have a fixed time of 5 years. I think this is an important, sir, give me 2 minutes, please.
One minute more, please.
I think it's an important recommendation.
You please sit down.
Whatever time we have to give
it. I think this is an important recommendation which delineates the tenure of the members of the DVC which governs the whole process. Standing committee also recommended the vending certificate should be issued within 1 month. The bill mysteriously does not provide any time limit for the TVC to issue a vending certificate. How long should a vendor wait for a certificate from the TVC? So these recommendations should be included. Another important recommendations of the standing committee, that vending certificate should be renewed every 3 years. This is also an important recommendation and should be included and bring in necessary amending to the bill. While ventilating my view, I am very careful about TVC not getting sweeping powers to decide on everything. Even our 65 years of independence, the government could not come out with a law which gives protection to the street vendors and streamline their livelihood. It does not augur well for the country. Till now, municipal law governs the street vendor. There are no dearth of laws and acts, but when it comes to implementation or reaching out to the needy, our country is lacking. With this bill, efforts are being made to bring the street vendors in the current list. I am hopeful with this bill, street vendors would heave a sigh.